Hey guys, it's Michael here. In today's video, I want to give you 6 tips that can help you to survive your first cold plunge or ice bath. Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and you click on the little alert button so you get notified when I publish more videos like this. I also want to mention that I have an in-depth review of the cold plunge that I'm using on my blog, as well as on my YouTube channel, and a couple of other articles that compare cold plunging with cryotherapy and other things. So check those out. I'm gonna link them all down below in the description. So let's go outside. I'm gonna jump into the cold plunge and I'm gonna give you the 6 tips that I've used and I've applied to make cold plunging a much more pleasant experience. All right, first tip before we get in, it's all in your head, remember that. Once you get in, once your toe touches the cold water, your brain is gonna tell you, get out, you're gonna go into a fight or flight response. You feel super uncomfortable and feel like you're gonna die in here, but it's all in your head. And try to remember that whatever your brain is trying to tell you, your brain just doesn't know that you're doing this on purpose. It thinks that you're in a life-threatening situation. You're not, you're perfectly fine, so keep yourself telling that and don't freak out. Try to ignore what your brain is trying to tell you. Number 2, pick a temperature that's uncomfortable but safe. There is no purpose of, you know, setting the lowest temperature on the cold plunge, getting in and then suffering from a panic attack. I'm not gonna mention any names, Richie and Kathy, but there's no purpose of doing that, getting in and then getting out after a few seconds because you couldn't handle it and then you don't wanna do it again. So pick a temperature that's cold, that's uncomfortable, but that's safe and that you can sustain for at least 30 seconds or maybe a minute. Tip number 3, we're gonna cover while I'm inside of the plunge. All right, tip number 3. The only thing you should be focusing on is breathing, and more importantly, slowing down your breathing. Because once you get in there, your respiratory rate is gonna increase, your heart rate is gonna increase, and you're going into fight or flight response. And the only way to counter this, or one of the best ways to counter this, is to close your eyes and channel all of your energy into slowing down your breathing. And even hold your breath if you have to. The way I do it, I typically leverage box breathing, meaning that I inhale on a count of maybe 5, I hold my breath for 5 seconds, I exhale on a count of 5, I hold my breath again, and I repeat that cycle. And so if you do the math, each breath cycle takes you 20 seconds. That means in 1 minute, you only have to breathe 3 times. And the first time I stayed in here for 3 minutes, I reached at a count of 8 and I was done. And I'm like, wow, this was so quick. Time passed so quickly. Because you only have to count to 8 in your head, and it's really the best way to forget everything and to distract your brain from screaming inside of your head, basically. And so focus on your breathing, focus on slowing down your breathing. Lie back, close your eyes, relax, and only focus on slowing down your breath. That's the most important tip I can give you. Number 4, don't look at the clock. If you keep looking at your clock, time is not gonna fly. Instead, what I suggest you do, you set a timer. Like on my Apple Watch, I typically use my timer. I set it up before I get in. I get in and I wait until my watch vibrates. The other thing that I've been doing that's super helpful as well, just play a song. Like one of my favorite songs is Ma Chérie, and I play that. It lasts approximately 3 minutes and 10 seconds, and I know once the song is over, I can get out. And the last tip, don't try to wiggle around and move a lot, because the more you move, the colder it feels. Instead, stay still, appreciate the suck, because it's gonna suck a little bit. You can even make a fist, because your fingers and your toes are likely the ones getting cold first. So make a fist, keep them close to your body, and just stay still and appreciate the discomfort for 2 minutes or so, and it's gonna be over in no time. So to wrap it up, number 1, understand that it's gonna be uncomfortable. It's supposed to, that's the whole purpose of it. Number 2, start with a water temperature that's uncomfortable, but that doesn't freak you completely out. And it obviously helps if you have something like the cold plunge that I have, where you can set the temperatures. You can start maybe with 55 or 50 degrees instead of going all the way down to 39 degrees from the get-go. Number 3, channel all of your energy into breathing, into slowing down your respiratory rate. That's really the number 1 tool that you can use to counter your fight or flight response. Number 4, don't look at the clock. Number 5, play some music or set a timer. Much easier and time will fly. And number 6, just embrace the suck and hold still. Don't wiggle around. Don't try to warm yourself up by moving. It's not gonna help. It's gonna feel colder. Just stay still, wait for 2 minutes, and it's gonna be over in no time. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, let me know in the comments what I could have done better. And make sure you check out my blog and my YouTube channel for all the other videos related to cold plunging, to cold therapy, and how the cold plunge or ice bath compare to cryotherapy. Until next time.